Good morning, students. So today in my session, I am going to start with 6th standard globe, latitudes and longitudes presented by me, Ramya K. So today I am going to cover session like longitude and time, how time was calculated during olden periods and how to calculate time on the basis of longitude, as I said in the earlier classes. So how time was calculated in the ancient period? See, you can see a small experiment here. You can take a cardboard and you can mark a circle over there, and with equal distance you can mark like 1, 2, 3, okay? And you have to keep a pole, or you can insert a pencil also, no issues with that. So if you insert a pencil, based on the shadow of the pencil you can calculate the time. Okay, so this is how in olden times the peoples used to calculate time. Okay, now let me enter into a very important concept, my dear students. See, you know this is earth. Okay, earth is little flattened over here and it is geoid in shape, right? Okay, so you know that we have divided the earth into 360 longitudes like this, right? We have divided earth into 360 longitudes like this. Okay, for completion of one rotation it takes, means one day and night, okay, it takes 24 hours. For completion of one rotation it takes 24 hours. Okay, that is, see, for one day and night, that is to complete 360 degrees, complete agi turn agakke, it takes 24 hours. And therefore I will tell you, see, 360, that is complete the longitudes, and total hours it takes. So one complete day it takes 24 hours. For one complete day it takes 24 hours. So for 1 hour it takes 15 minutes. I want you all to calculate this. So 360 divided by 24, it will give you 15 degrees. That is, for 1 hour it will complete 360 degrees. Okay, let me calculate for 1 minute, that is 60. For 1 minute, 60 seconds divided by 50, divided by 15. Okay, so it will give you 4 degrees. Means for 1 minute, it completes 4 degrees. I hope this concept is very clear for you students, right? So earth takes 360 degrees to complete 24 hours, and therefore for 1 hour it takes 15 degrees, and for 1 minute it completes 4 degrees. Okay, so let me enter into like how time will be calculated. So this is our world map. I think you can see the time zones here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and all, right? Can you see the time zones here? Yes. Next, I have an assignment for you actually. Okay, in 0 degree, the time is 6 o'clock. In 0 degree, the time is 6 o'clock. Find the time in 60 degree east. Find the time in 60 degree east. Okay, so here they are telling the time over here in 0 degree. I think this is 0 degree. So this particular time is, sorry, in this particular time is 6 o'clock it seems. Okay, and we have to find the time for 60 degrees. You know the earth rotates, right? For every hour 15 degree is rotated. So let us assume this is 15 degree, this is 30 degree, this is 45 degree and this is 60 degree towards the east. Okay, towards the east. So if this is 0 degree here, and if it is 6 o'clock here, and here it will be obviously 7 o'clock, because 15 degree it has been rotated over here, and this will be 8 o'clock, and this will be 9 o'clock, and this will be 10 o'clock. Right, students? So 0, 15, 30, 45 and 60 degrees. So it will come up to 10 o'clock. So the answer for this is 10 o'clock. Okay. And next, the question here is, in 0 degree, the time is 6 o'clock. Find the time in 60 degree west. Find the time in 60 degree west. So see here, this is 0 degree, right? So if you move towards here, it will be always ahead. As I said you, the earth moves from east to west. So therefore, this will be always ahead. Idu munde irutte. Okay, this will be always there. Like the time always will be more here. And when if you come over here, it will be very less. Okay, so what they are telling is towards the west. If this is 6 o'clock, this is 15 degree, this is 30 degree, this is 45 degree, and this is 60 degree. So if this is 6 o'clock, this will be 7 o'clock, this will be 8 o'clock, this will be 9 o'clock, and this will be 10 o'clock. Do you think so like that? No, students, it is not like that. See, you calculate here because time moves forward. But here you cannot calculate like that. Here what you should do is, this is the major mistake that each and every student does. Here, if this is 0 degree, see, if this is 0 degree and this is 6 o'clock here, this is 15 degree, this is 30 degree, this is 45 degree and this is 60 degree. You have to go back. That is 5, that is 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock and 2 o'clock. Okay? You cannot count the same way you count over here. You have to count less here. Okay? So, therefore it is 2 o'clock. It is, for this the answer is 2 o'clock and for this the answer is 10 o'clock. So, I hope you would have understood that how time is calculated, and this particular time, you know, like longitudes and latitudes, how it is useful is for flights and for those people who have to work abroad. Okay, you would have seen many software engineers, they would be like working from night. You would have wondered why they are working at night. The reason is their head office will be in USA. And therefore, they have to calculate time based on those time, and they have to work upon that time. For example, I'll tell you exactly what happens. See, over here, this is India, okay? This is India. And the head office might be in Europe somewhere here. Okay, so the time over here, when we have like 6 o'clock in the morning, the same timings will not be there for them. They'll be still sleeping. Okay, so what people will do is, that is IT professionals especially, they will calculate the time based on the head office time, and then they work. So therefore night shift works will be done. Okay, thank you students. I hope you would, this video is very informative for you. Thank you so much.